I'm actually a believer in Ayn Rand. I don't believe everything Ayn Rand said, a few controversial things.
How many times did you read Atlas Shrugged?
I only got, that's too big. I only read that one. But.
What does Anthem own?
So we have the Fight Network, which is the combat sports channel, and that is distributed in Canada, US, and 30 other countries. And we also own the Fantasy Sports Network, which I really call the Fantasy Sports Group, because there's a TV channel, there's a full 24/7 radio network, there are websites that sell premium data products for, think of like investor newsletters. We have a large interest in a hunting and fishing channel called Pursuit Channel.
I can't imagine, and that's big.
Oh, that's huge. That's the largest asset we have, actually. There are 87 million people in the United States with hunting and fishing licenses. As part of the Fight Network, we have something called Impact Wrestling, which is our newest thing,
Who doesn't love wrestling?
Well, I have to say, I couldn't believe, actually, how passionate the fans are there. I knew it, but I didn't really know until I got into it again. I used to, watch it growing up.
Did you reenact the moves when you were growing up? Why Anthem? What's Anthem?
I'm a big Rush fan. So the album Fly By Night has a song on it called Anthem.
Are they going to be coming back looking for royalties?
They might be. So I'll happily pay them, or I'll change the name if they want me to.
Now, in August of 2016, the Air Canada Centre in Toronto, 20,000 people sold out for League of Legends esports.
Yeah.
That is a culture I don't understand, but it looks like it's going big time.
Yeah. You know, what we pride ourselves on doing as a company is taking trending sports and getting behind them. So, combat sports was the first one, and like I say, hunting and fishing is getting, bigger and bigger. So esports is, it's one of our next targets.
Because you're such a wrestling aficionado, if you will, I have some questions for you.
I don't know much. Okay, but
I think you'll get them. Whose signature finishing move was the leg drop? Was it Hulk Hogan, or was it Randy the Macho Man Savage?
I think it was Randy Savage.
Hulk Hogan.
I didn't say it was a wrestling conviction. I said I'm a business guy who wants to own wrestling.
Got another question for you.
Okay.
Ronda Rousey.
Yes.
Versus Amanda Nunes. Was that match 48 seconds or 4 minutes and 8 seconds?
I'm saying 48 seconds.
Ding, 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 ding.
Okay, I think that was fast.
Okay, very good.
Yeah. I bet you didn't come up with these questions.
We Googled.
Yeah.
So last question is, this guy once worked as a bouncer in a Montreal club. Mm-hmm. He once worked as a garbage collector, 3-time UFC champion. Is it George St. Pierre or Randy Couture?
Well, you're giving me a little bit of an easy one here. Yeah, I'm going to go with Georges St. Pierre on that one. I know a little bit about both of those guys. So
presenting the world champion.
Oh my God,
Len the Lion.
Oh, wow.